Hey everyone, and welcome back to our channel. Today we're going to go over the difference between nominal interest rate and the real interest rate. We'll go over what each of them means, as well as to provide a couple of examples to really help you grasp the concept. With that said, let's get right into it. Let's start with a relatively simple question. Is 70% a good interest rate? Well, the answer to this question could be classified as ambiguous or open to interpretation, as the answer depends on who you ask. What I mean is this: if you're the lender, that is the person lending out their money with the intent on receiving the principal amount of money back plus interest, then absolutely, 70% is a phenomenal interest rate. This would mean that if you lent someone $100, when they pay you back, you'll get your principal $100 plus an additional 70%, which is $70, totaling a repayment of $170. Not a bad return on investment, if you ask me. However, there are two sides to every coin, and if you are the borrower, that is the person borrowing money with the intent on repaying the principal amount of money back plus interest, then an interest rate of 70% is terrible. This would mean that if you borrowed $500, for example, when you pay it back, you'll owe the principal $500 plus an additional 70%, which is $350, totaling a repayment of $850. You end up paying back a lot more than you originally borrowed, so obviously this is not something you want. So that's a brief rundown on what interest rates are and how they work. But what's the difference between nominal and real interest rates? After all, that's why you clicked on the video in the first place, isn't it? Well, the two examples we just went over are looking at nominal interest rates. They are simply the interest rates without taking inflation into account. Now remember, inflation is the increase of the general price level over time, and therefore the deterioration or the decline in value of your money. Consider it this way. This year, your $100 can purchase more than it will be able to at this same time next year. But why is that? It's $100 this year, and it will still be $100 next year. So why can't I buy the same amount of goods with it? Well, the prices of the goods that you could buy have increased, meaning that you can't purchase the same bundle of goods for $100. You've lost purchasing power over the course of a year. That's inflation, and it's typically a percentage rate. So suppose the inflation rate is 2%, then next year you would expect goods to be 2% more expensive, and therefore our current $100 can't afford everything it can afford this year, next year. So back to the topic at hand. Now we know what the nominal interest rate is, and we know what the inflation rate is. So what about the real interest rate? Well, that's the easy part. The formula for the real interest rate is the nominal interest rate minus the expected inflation rate. Why the expected inflation rate, you might ask? Well, the bank doesn't actually know what next year's inflation rate will be. In fact, no one does. So the bank's making an educated approximation based on many factors. This approximation is the expected inflation rate. So with this formula, given any two pieces of information, we can solve for the third unknown with some simple rearranging of the equation. So let's try out some examples together. If the nominal interest rate is 10% and inflation is 2%, what is our real interest rate? Well, following our formula, it's simply 10% minus 2%, which is 8%. Let's try another one. If the nominal interest rate is 2% and the real interest rate is negative 3%, what is the inflation rate? Well, by rearranging our formula, it's simply 2% minus negative 3%, which is 5%. And lastly, if the real interest rate is 5% and the inflation rate is 4%, what is our nominal interest rate? Well, after rearranging our formula once again, it's simply 5% plus 4%, which is 9%. I hope you got all of these examples correct. If you didn't, consider reviewing the formula once again and practice some more. Remember, given any two pieces of information, the nominal interest rate, the inflation rate, or the real interest rate, you can always solve for the third value simply by solving or rearranging, then solving the equation we looked at here today. So there you have it. Now you know the difference between nominal interest rates and real interest rates, as well as how to calculate them. We just wanted to take a second to thank each and every one of you for all the support that you've shown. It really means a lot to us. And as usual, if you liked the video and are excited to see more, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and comment what sort of economic topics you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.